Yeah, grace and peace to you all. This is Pastor Pimpong. Today I want to make a comment, perhaps two comments, on the one has to do with Pastor Benny Hinn's confession that he made, a public confession he made. And the second one, also I want to speak to the many bishops, quote-unquote apostles, those who have come out against what he did, some even going on YouTube and on Facebook, you know, speaking as if what he did was a crime when he needed to be commended. You know, I'll start by commending Benny Hinn, whose actually doctrines in the past have really, even up to the time when he made a confession, I didn't agree with most of them. But I think it is very good for him to come out boldly. This is something that I have been praying. I know there are many people who have been praying and asking God to really expose and also to expose and to rebuke and to correct this false doctrine of prosperity that is going on. And so to have him come out and to speak so forcefully to that particular doctrine, I think he needs to be commended. And I will urge him to go on to do as Zacchaeus did. You know, Zacchaeus in the book of Luke. You know, Zacchaeus, when Jesus Christ met Zacchaeus, or should I say when Zacchaeus met Jesus Christ, the first utterance that Zacchaeus made, Jesus said, "Zacchaeus, come down. I'm going to your house today." And Zacchaeus' response was, look, he sees himself as unworthy. I can see. And then he confesses. He said, look, everything that I've taken, the monies I've taken from the people, I'm going to give back in many folds. So I want to encourage my brother. Now I call him my brother because he's repented. And I'm trusting that it's a sincere repentance. And I'm praying that he will conclude, do it to the fullest by retaining those monies that he's collected, like Zacchaeus did exactly as Zacchaeus did, if you really mean what you are saying. Having said that, you know, I want to speak against those who have come out, you know, speaking against him, as if they are implying that he should retract his confession. Why? Because it affects them. Why? Because it exposes them. Why? Because it eats into their conscience. The masses of the people that they are misleading, they feel like if they don't do that, the people will leave. But my friend, I want to say this. Where are we going to take all that money that we are extorting from the people? You know, I hear this doctrine about seed time, harvest time. It's in the book of Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Now, if you read the story of the flood, Noah, God was speaking to Noah. In fact, in verse 21 of chapter 8, it says, Noah offered sacrifice. And the sacrifice has a very sweet smell. God smelled it and God loved it. And so God in verse 22 told Noah, as long as the earth remains. Now I want you to listen to it. As long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest time, it has nothing to do with money, my beloved. It has everything to do with agroeconomy. It has everything to do with farming and harvesting. That is what God meant at that time, and still means that seed time and harvest time. It is only those, Paul describes this, he says, men with corrupt minds who think gain is godliness. In 1 Timothy chapter 6, those are the people who have twisted the word of God and they have used that to bait God's flock into giving. You know, and those are the people who are running scared, because they see their gospel, that false gospel, being exposed. You know, to talk about the fact that, you know, one bishop, perhaps I don't even need to call his name. You know, I was listening to him and well, I'll call his name, Pastor Bloomer, you know, talking as if he was coming against Benny Hinn to justify their doctrine. You know, listen, God blesses, yes. God does not intend for you and I to be in abject poverty. That's true. But does it mean that we don't have poor people amongst us? You know why there are poor people amongst us? So that those of us who are blessed will be a conduit. But the problem is that so many have become stopgaps, greedy. You want to have it all to yourself. So in your church, you are saying sow. And when you are telling the people to sow, do you know what you are telling them to sow into your life? That's why so many of you are walking around there, flying in the air with your private jet, boasting. In fact, the book of Timothy talks about, in the last days, men shall be boastful, proud, arrogant. And that is what we have today behind the pulpits. I preach that. And I'm not afraid and ashamed to preach. I'm afraid to preach that. You know, men have gotten filthily rich, whether it is by writing books or tapes or whatever it is. Who do you sell them to the congregation? And you give them scriptures to try to make them feel guilty if they don't buy your book. And you tell them they have to buy 20. Some have to buy 100. Some, if you give it to them by force, they have to take it. You know, what Benny Hinn was saying was truth. He is saying that, look, he is no longer going to tell people to give $1,000 because that is not what God said we should do. In fact, in the book of Genesis, God told Moses to tell the children of Israel to bring, actually, I think the book of Exodus, to bring, you know, to take from them gold, silver, to build. That was when they were building the temple, to bring. And he says, take it only from those who will give willingly. He didn't say you should use force. But what we find today is gimmicks, craft. If you give, we are going to give you this. Where in the Bible does the Lord tell you to give somebody a bottle of water or a bottle of juice? So if he gives $1,000, that is gimmick. That is craftiness. And Paul writes about that in the book of Corinthians, 2 Corinthians. He said, we are not like those who handle the word of God with craftiness and with deceit. And today, the pulpit is filled with people who are deceitful, who are money lovers. Money lovers. The other one of them who talks about it, he said, I love money. And then he turned the word of God, how great this hymn, sacred hymn, how great thou art, he's turned it and he says, how dumb thou art. It holds a dollar new, it's a love, the new fresh $20 note, the new fresh $50 note, the new fresh $100 note. And he's boasting and bragging about that on YouTube. Where does the word of God tell us to do that? So those of you who have risen up against this man, he is just stating the mere fact. The fact of the, he said, he's not going to tell anybody to give $1,000 because God's blessings, God's healings, God's miracles are not for sale. And that is a fact. In the book of Exodus 23, where the Lord says, thou shalt not, no one shall come without an offering. He's not talking about people giving $1,000. Certainly when people come to church, they have to come and give the offerings. That's not what Benny Hinn was kicking against. He never said that nobody should give offering. All he's saying that we don't have to tell people to give $1,000 so they'll be healed, $1,000 so they receive miracles, $1,000 so they... No. He's saying the truth. He's saying the truth. You know, and we, those of us who call ourselves the clergy, by the way, let me say this. Bishop Bloomer, you don't represent me. When you say that you are on behalf of all the clergy, you don't represent me. And I know there are many decent-minded, sound-minded clergies around the world who will tell you the same thing, that you don't represent them. We don't preach your kind of gospel. God prospers his people. But God doesn't raise greedy ministers. God doesn't do that. And God doesn't use craft to get money. He says the money belongs to him. He owns the riches. and he blesses us. You know, God's blessings are not for sale. Talking about Danny Willis, that when Danny Willis gave $1,000, and if he accepted the rebuke that Benny Hinn gave, then it means that he's revoking God's blessings. That's a lie. That's a lie. Please, let's be very truthful. That's a lie. He didn't pay $1,000 for his son to be healed. God healed, he would heal his son whether he gave $1,000 or not. I am a miracle. I had a spinal injury. I didn't pay a dime. I went before God fasting 7 days. The problem with so many of us is that we take the cheap way out. We ourselves don't fast. We go about talking about Daniel's fast, and all. We just love food. When was the last time you went on a 7 days dry fast? I'm talking about no food, no water. Well, my doctor said I should eat, drink. But that is what it takes to meet God, to have an encounter with all the apostles, Moses, from Moses all the way, Old Testament. You see, every one of them that had an encounter with God, they fasted. Dry fasting. No water, no food. Moses, for 80 days, no water, no food. He went before God. That is what brings the presence of God. You know, in the New Testament, Jesus, 40 days and 40 nights. Paul, in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 11, you can see how he talks. Many fastings, many, all nights, many. All those things are there. Nowhere did any one of them say that, come and sow seed and God will bless you. That is a lie. So let's teach the pure gospel, and let's commend Bishop Benny Hinn for the step that he has taken. Let's commend him and pray for him that he will move a step further, you know, to do to the fullest, that will come out and say, hey, look, by the way, I am giving back all this. This is my $1 million home. This is my private jet plane I bought out of this thing. I'm giving them back. I'm selling them a return. That's me, because his soul is very, very important, just as your soul and every one of us. Remember, we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we're taking nothing out. The love of money is the root of all evil. And sadly, though, those people who have made money their God, have twisted it and said the lack of money is the root of all evil, turning the word of God on his head. We don't fear God. We don't have the fear of God. Please, let's leave Benny Hinn alone. He's done the right thing. We pray for him that he will proceed to the next step. Okay? So, Pastor Bloomer, please, I don't agree with you, what you said. And if you would kindly go back and retract. You said you are waiting for Benny Hinn. I'm also waiting for you to retract that statement that you made and say that on behalf of all the clergy, that is out of arrogance and pride. None of us elected you to speak on our behalf. So please take that one back. And I am waiting to have you go on Facebook and retract that statement. You are not representing any one of us. Maybe you are representing yourself. Just as you said that Benny Hinn represented, he's saying on him, representing himself, you're also representing yourself. So limit it to yourself, because we don't preach your doctrine. Okay? We don't pray. For the 50 years that I've walked with God, you've not heard me. I don't beg for money. My crusades, when I hold crusade, we don't take offering. When I go on radio to preach, I don't take money. I don't ask for money. TV, I don't ask for money. I don't beg. But God has faithfully taken care of us. No, I'm not a millionaire. I'm not a thousandaire. Neither am I a hundredaire. No. God supplies my need every day. And like Paul, I have learned in every state that I am to be content. Contentment is the key. The problem is that so many of these people who have arrogated to themselves these titles of bishops, apostles, whatever it is, you know, no contentment. You are not content. You are constantly after. And that is what brings all this problem. We need to repent. Benny Hinn has set a precedent, a good one. And so many of us have to follow. Rather than kicking against him, let us humble ourselves and do a thorough self-examination. Peradventure, God will give us grace to repent so that heaven will be our home. Otherwise, the Lord will say to most of us, I never knew you. But God, I raised all these $1 million. I never knew you. I never knew you. So let's really humble ourselves. This is the moment of thorough self-examination amongst those who call themselves whatever. Okay? This is the moment where we have to let go of the flock of God. Freedom from the bondage. Freedom. Read the book of Jeremiah, chapter 5. It says they have had a cage. The people have been caged. That is what is happening. And the prophets prophesy lies. And the priests, they preach according to their means. Jeremiah 5, Isaiah chapter 6, all of them speak to this one. Okay? Look at it and see what God is saying. My beloved, this is what I want to say. Again, I want to commend Benny Hinn for what he has taken, and I pray that he doesn't go back. He proceeds and takes Zacchaeus' line. Surrender, give all, and put the devil to shame. And those of you who want to continue to swim in that field of greed, continue. Jesus Christ said, I am coming. He said, behold, I come quickly. Behold, I come quickly. Let the unjust be unjust still. Let the filthy be filthy still. For I am coming with my reward in my hand to give to everyone. So this is a moment of repentance. Pastor Pimpong here. I rest my case. Finito. Grace and peace. Bye-bye.